Hello, everyone. Meteorologist Mike Haddad here in the Storm Watch 9 Weather Center. An update on Hurricane Henri, a minimal hurricane. However, packing winds sustained anyway around the center of 75 miles per hour and moving at a pretty good clip off to the north and northeast at 18 miles per hour. It will likely slow down a little bit in its forward speed towards southern New England during tomorrow morning and early afternoon. And at the same time, steering currents in the atmosphere and a trough of low pressure to the west of it will help kick it back a little bit more to the northwest. And that means likely landfall of a minimal hurricane or very strong tropical storm somewhere along the eastern part of Long Island or eastern portions of Connecticut, right near the Rhode Island border. That looks to be the most favored area to make landfall during the midday or early to mid-afternoon tomorrow. Then beyond that, a little bit more of a turn northwest for a few more hours. And the latest change from the National Hurricane Center and some of the computer models, which of course goes into the decision making for the track, now has a little bit more of a turn back to the east a little bit earlier. Instead of jogging west into western Connecticut, this turn a little bit more to the east means a greater chance, not a widespread flooding issue, but a greater shot of getting in on some heavier rain and a potential for some flooding, mostly in the western part of the state and more impressively in the Monadnock region. Beyond that, the remnant low from Henri looks to slowly build through during Monday and Monday night before pivoting out to sea, off to the east rather, during the day on Tuesday. So, impacts from Henri look to be medium statewide, but it's not going to be a one-size-fits-all by any stretch. Heavy rain at this point looks to be a low impact north and east of Concord until you get into the White Mountains, where you could see some downpours at times. But the best bet of flooding in this medium impact appears to be in western and especially southwestern New Hampshire. There may be some additional flooding issues on Monday as more showers and storms slowly build through with the remnants of the circulation from Henri. 40 mile per hour winds. Again, tropical storm winds are 39 miles per hour stronger. We're talking about that medium impact in southern New Hampshire for some winds possibly as high as 40 to 45. Now, that's just strong enough to result in some scattered power outages. So we'll be watching out for that. Should not be a widespread problem, and not anticipating the wind to be a widespread issue for the Granite State. How about the waves and coastal flooding? A medium impact centered around the time of high tide. That looks to be in the cards as we go into later Sunday night. The high tide is just after midnight, later Sunday evening, and that's when we could see some issues for minor flooding along the coast. So 30 to 40 mile per hour winds look likely. Southern New Hampshire, slightly higher gusts, and the greatest chance of flooding in southwestern parts of the state during Sunday afternoon and Sunday night. Seas building to 3 to 6 feet, if not a bit higher, Sunday afternoon, Sunday night before subsiding. And again, here is the greatest chance of that wind field over 40 miles per hour from Concord Point south with a few higher gusts, low impact with wind the farther north that you do go. Keep it tuned here to the latest updates every step of the way. We'll keep close tabs and update you on the new track and timeline and possible impacts for New Hampshire as we go through Saturday evening and again early on Sunday morning.